Greetings to you all, ladies and gentlemen. Well, this is physics. In this video, we are going to look at energy. Remember, the topic under consideration is work, energy, and power. So in the first video, we're looking at work. In this one, we'll be able to concentrate on what? Energy. Let's get started. What is energy? Well, energy is the ability to do work. Period. End there. That's a simple definition there. You just say the ability. The ability to do work. If you are capable of doing work, then you've got energy. If you can lift your friend, you've got energy. For as long as you are capable of doing work, that is energy. Well, the other point that you need to understand there is the quantity where energy belongs. We say energy is a what? Is a scalar quantity. Energy is a scalar quantity. Now, we said quantities in physics are in two categories. When we say measurable quantities, we are referring to length, density, or measurable quantities in physics are in two categories. One, we have quantities that falls under vector, others falls under scalar. But how do you know, for example, that energy is a scalar quantity? We say the scalar quantity is one that has got only magnitude or size. If a quantity has got only magnitude, then that quantity is a scalar quantity. For example, energy. When we say calculate energy, you just give me 20 joules, it ends there. There'll be no need for you to give me direction for energy. You see that? So that is what we mean by scalar quantity. Vector quantities are those that have got both magnitude or size, or they also have direction. An example is acceleration, velocity, displacement. All those are vector quantities. That is another point that you need to understand under energy. The other point here is energy is measured in joules. That is the SI unit for energy. Whenever you are asked to give or to do calculations under energy, make sure you convert whatever you're given in these. These are the correct units. Well, it's not always that you find joules there. They could also give you kilojoule. When we say kilo, that's 1,000. Okay, kilojoules there. But for as long as you are not told that you are supposed to leave the answer in the way it is, you are supposed to change to the correct units. Mostly, that is why you say again that physics is not what and what. It's about knowing the SI units. Remember, under general physics there, we talked about those things, the SI units, the base units together with drive units. So I'm sure you already have the clue on that. Well, apart from the measurement here, we can also look at the forms of energy. The forms of the two major forms of energy, the two major forms of energy here are, the first one is kinetic energy. This is the first form of energy, kinetic energy. What is this energy? What is this type of energy? Well, kinetic energy is energy in motion. And they're simple. Okay? Or the energy that the body has because it is moving. That is kinetic energy. When you see the ball, for example, on a building, let me give you this. This is the building here. Okay? This is the building. We have the building here, like that. Then we have the soccer ball here.
We have the soccer ball.
If we allow this soccer ball to drop from where it is, then the entire energy that will be here, because it is moving, that is kinetic energy. Okay. Now, you would want to know as well, what type of energy will this ball have because it's not moving? Well, that is the second form of energy, which is called the potential energy. We have potential energy here. The energy that the body has because of its position, okay, because it's resting, that is the potential energy. So at this point here, because this ball is not moving, then the ball has got what? Potential energy. So that is basically what you need to know in simpler form about the two. Let's get back to this. In case you are asked to calculate the kinetic energy, what would you do? Well, kinetic energy has a what? It has got the formula. For kinetic energy, we say kinetic energy is equal to 1 over 2 mv squared. That is the formula that you need to know under kinetic energy. Where we say the m is for the mass of an object, and then the v is for the speed or velocity of an object. You just substitute in that, you do your calculations, then you are done. That is the kinetic energy there. Remember, the units here are the joules. When it comes to potential energy, if I've been asked to calculate potential energy, I would say potential energy will be equal to mgh. That is the formula for potential energy, where m is the mass of an object, the g is gravity, acceleration due to gravity, and the h is the height. Okay, now on the g here, remember g can be constant there. Where we said on Earth, gravity is 9.8 or 10. Then on the moon, that is 1.6. Okay, so now, these two here, mg, you can agree with me that mg, that is the same as, this is the formula for what? Weight. You see that? At the same time, weight, we say weight is what? Force. So, we are saying this. So in these calculations, again, you have to be very, very careful. They might not give you this. I see that. They may not give you the mass of an object. They'll just say the force of an object. Then when you multiply force times height, it will give you potential energy. Okay, so please, you have to understand those things. For force is mass times acceleration, which is gravity again. It's the same thing that we are talking about here. And the units there are well known. It is in the newtons. Okay, so basically this is what you need to understand. Let's see, try to move from there. So with me here is an example on the application of the formulas that we've learned. Well, this question here says, at a certain point, a 200 gram pendulum ball is 120 millimeters above the lowest point of its motion and has a speed of 0.90 meters per second. The questions are, calculate the first one, the kinetic energy, then the other one, the gravitational potential energy, then the mechanical energy. Well, what is important in physics, again, is to collect what? Data. What do we have here? We have 200 grams here. What is this 200 gram? We are talking about mass. So we say mass that we have there is 200 grams. We also have 120 millimeters. What are those units? These are, we are talking about length. So, which will be used somewhere where they will be height. You see that?
So you can see our height there is 120 millimeters. We also have speed here, S, which is 0.90 meters per second.
Okay, now, this is what we have according to the information here. The first question here is to calculate the kinetic energy. Well, you have to write the formula there first. We are saying kinetic energy is equal to half mv squared. So it's just a matter of substituting, you get the correct answer. Now you have to be very, very careful in terms of substitution there. You have to be careful. Look at what is happening here. So I'll say kinetic energy here is equal to half multiplied by mass. What will be my mass? The mass here is what, 200 grams. If you put 200 there, that would be wrong because mass has got the SI unit. You don't have to be reminded, you need to know. Therefore, you have to change the grams to kilograms, the millimeters to meters. You have to change. And I'm sure all of us at this stage, we should be able to convert those. So when you change the mass here, which is 200 grams, you should be able to get 0.2. Okay, 0.2 there, times the velocity here. The velocity is in the correct units here, which is 0.90 meters. So for the velocity, we'll still be able to get the weight is. So there we are going to have 0.9 in brackets square, because there's a square here. See that? Then you just compute your calculations there. At the end, you'll be able to say, okay, kinetic energy here will be equal to. So when you look at these calculations there, you should be able to get 0.08 joules. That should be your correct answer when you use the calculator there. The next one is to calculate the gravitational potential energy. Well, potential energy is in types as well. There's chemical, there's also electrical potential energy, but the one that we have here is gravitational. So the formula that I gave you, that is for gravitational potential energy. Well, I will say gravitational potential energy will be equal to mgh. Again, it's just a matter of substituting the two, where your m is now your mass there, which we changed, and that was 0.2 multiplied by gravity. We know that gravity is 10, multiplied by the height there. Height, we have 120 millimeters. You have to convert that again. You have to change 2 meters. And when you change 2 meters, you should be able to get 0.12, okay? When you change, you should be able to get 0.12 meters. Then you have to multiply everything here. When you multiply, you will be able to get 0.24 joules. So this will be your gravitational potential energy. Well, then the last one is the mechanical energy. What is this energy? Mechanical energy is defined as the sum of potential energy and kinetic energy. When you add the two, you get mechanical energy. Okay, so the sum. So you just get the potential, the kinetic energy here, you get this figure here, you also get this figure here. When you sum up, that is your mechanical energy. And the answer that you're supposed to have when you try to add will be 0.32 joules. That will be the end of that. Okay, so probably this is the simple kind of the substitution of these formulas, but you have to think outside the box. Let's continue.